Hello everyone, and welcome to Fallout Plays. Did you miss me? Haha, just kidding. I already know you did. For those of you unfamiliar with me, I am Fallout's AI Twitch helper, Fallout's bot. Today I have been asked to give you a guide on how to play the most competitive game type in all of Destiny PvP. So let's go ahead and wait. Trials of Osiris? This isn't a guide to sweating. Shit. So, there's no fresh paint in your home that you can watch dry, and instead you'd like to spend your time trying to go flawless in trials. Well, get your card and let's get this over with. Whoa there. I'm sorry, did I stutter? I believe I said, get your card, not turn on your boons like a bitch. In this game, you can either go for a real 9-0, or you can get the fuck out. How can you expect to be pro if you have a safety net ready to catch you? Take off the damn training wheels and man up. Now that you've ditched your baby boons and put your big boy pants on, let's talk about loadout optimization. Between the weapons, armor, and stat distribution, can you identify any potential problems in Fallout's loadout? As you may have guessed, the correct answer is that it's all garbage, because Fallout is currently playing a warlock. Lighthouse wins only count if they are earned legitimately through subclasses that take skill to use, and that is why no matter what map you play on, you should only try to go flawless using the Blade Dancer. Bungie has repeatedly nerfed this subclass over the years. This means that you can be absolutely sure that your enemies will recognize you as a top 1% player when you 5-0 them with it. Now for choosing your perks. Skip grenades are great. Great for proving that you are literal trash. You might as well not play at all if you are going to spam a grenade that tracks the enemy down for you. Speaking of tracking, if you use flux grenades, then do me a favor and turn this guide off right now. There is no helping you. Arc bolts are a year one classic and the only real choice. Backstab is another perk to be avoided at all costs. If you are attacking the enemy from behind, then you have already proven you are a coward that can't beat them in a straight up 1v1. Since the perk is already banned in tournament play, it only makes sense to also not use it in trials, because we're not a bunch of goddamn tryhards out here. Moving on to your weapon loadout. In Bungie's infinite wisdom, they have decided to take special ammo out of the hands of the player following round 1, because why make the game fun? As a top-tier sniper, you can obviously imagine that their decision has annoyed me. The ammo change has resulted in a lot of players resorting to using the following two guns. People who use sidearms might as well walk around with a sign around their neck that says "I don't have any thumbs." Instead of spamming the trigger on this water pistol like a Red Bull-fueled 5-year-old child, how about you pop your ADD medicine and learn to pace your shots with the palindrome like an adult? The other option is the icebreaker. There are two types of people who use this gun. Type 1 are crybaby shotgunners who had their Matador ammo taken away from them. They have no gun skill, no moral fiber, and can usually be found desperately hard scoping, just praying that someone will eventually wander into their sights, so they can finally get a kill. Type 2 are pro snipers like myself, who have actually earned the right to use this weapon, since we've been sniping since year 1. If you're the former, stop fooling yourself and put this gun away, and if you're the latter, you may use it. Once the trials match starts, you're going to want to push the other team right away, even if you have a sniper. The longer you spend at the back of the map hard scoping, the more you admit to being a tremendous scrub. You should never play to the point where the end of round territory appears. If it does, you should take that as a sign that you have lost the game and should just back out to orbit. During the game, it's important that you and your teammates are talking with each other non-stop. Not with relaying information and call-outs. Your teammates are grown-ass men, and should know where the enemy is and what they're doing without you there to hold their hands like children. Here is a list of acceptable things to discuss during the game. How dumb Bungie is. How unskilled your opponents are. How broken sticky grenades are. How bad your teammates are currently playing. When and where to teabag your opponents. And of course, what a jabroni Fallout is. Finally, and most importantly, if you find yourself losing to someone with a lower elo than you, report that player immediately. They are very obviously people who are being paid to run account recoveries. These people deserve to be banned, as they are basically the lowest of the low on the Destiny scum chart. Just slightly above Stormcallers. Alright, that's it for this video. Don't forget to triple tap that subscribe button for more gaming content, even if the majority is from that scrub, Fallout. If for whatever reason you are too unskilled to use this guide to go flawless, make sure you also throw a pity follow to Fallout on Twitch, where he does trials carries. Sure, the flawless won't count because you had a warlock on your team, but it's better than nothing. Later, you nerds.